Aloha and welcome to beautiful Punahou campus for tonight's Clash of the Titans battle featuring the Newport Harbor Sailors against the Hawaii Baptist Academy Eagles. We got two very competitive teams. They've got good reputations. You want to talk about a little that, Peter?
Well, you know, both have historically have been, you know, really strong programs. You know, the Eagles from HBA come with a lot of ball control. They always play with a lot of tenacity, and they really, you know, they're indicative of their coach, Tony Obrey, and they play good, hard, fundamental volleyball. Newport Harbor, you know, is always kind of a contender in the CIAF from one year to the next. Some years they may be down in some talent, but they always battle, you know.
And perennial powerhouse, you said.
Very much so. You know, Danny Glenn has been there for 25 years, 26 years, something like that, and just does a wonderful job of teaching fundamentals and the game plan and just a great, great coach. So it should be a great battle today.
We got the two teams coming out the lines to exchange gifts. They've been exchanging some interesting gifts with each other the last couple nights.
Yeah, they look like they've got, you know, usually they bring something that's, you know, kind of specific to their school that's in kind of a special thing here. I would imagine, you know, the Eagles are going to bring something that's you know, special to Hawaii and, you know.
We're getting set for the PA announcements in a few minutes, but we get a good shot of the teams shaking hands before the game.
Here you've got a picture of Chris Matsui there, HBA's top libero. You know, this kid has really come a long ways, and last year had a breakout year at the varsity, and he's having a real good year again this year. But I think he's one that kind of is a difference maker,
right,
in a match like this.
It's interesting to see the two teams lined up shaking hands next to each other. I think we see a size difference between the two teams right
yeah.
off the bat, don't we?
Yeah, you know, HBA kind of typically from year in and year out has kind of a smaller stature in their team. But, you know, they got three pretty good-sized guys, their go-to guys in Beretta and Ryan Long and, what's the other kid's name? Oh, the freshman kid this year, Michael Fisher. Yeah. So they'll match up with their size all right.
And boy, has Tony Obrey done a fantastic job bringing this program along.
You know, he really has. Done a wonderful job. And I think that, you know, the mark of the program there is Darren Oshiro, the AD, was, you know, smart enough to hire him on and you know, give him a full-time status and whatnot.
We'll hear a lot more about him as the game goes on. Lots of interesting things. He's got baseball running through his family, a little sister here at Punahou.
Yeah, he's definitely tied into, you know, Punahou and the volleyball world, and, you know, it'll be great.
All right, we're going to get set and just start this game right from the jump here. Got Coach Glenn already giving his team instructions.
Yeah, you know, it's important, both these teams, you know, they had spurts last night, and it's important that they both get off on a good track and, you know, play well right from the start. So,
well, the ref sends out the first ball, and we got the serve coming up from number 12, Jackson Carmack. Floater to the middle, Matsui to the outside. Strong spike.
Well, that's the kind of thing you're going to see out of HBA. You know, Matsui, you know, makes a great pass, makes it real easy for
textbook,
West to tie.
Right?
Yeah.
It's,
you know, and Ryan going right over
sure
the top.
Sure, Obrey called that. All right, Matsui with the jump floater to the middle. Bad pass.
Yeah, you know, he didn't start last night. You know, Ian Sakara, they had a different libero last night, so they're going after him, see if he can handle the pressure right off the bat.
Matsui with another jump floater in the middle of the net. We got a 2-1 score. Hawaii Baptist with the jump serve to the middle. High pass, short set. Good dig to the middle. Bump set. Outside, no one there to cover.
Well, there you go with the height mismatch. He just went over and deep. A nice crisp shot, giving himself a chance to get in the flow of the game, just aim for the big part of the court. That's a
looks
great
like,
hit.
Looks like something went wrong with the defense also. There's a big hole.
Well, you kind of get, you got to give something up, you know, and they gave that corner up, and shoot, that kid just went up and just stroked that thing for the corner. Just a great hit, real smart.
Jump serve, pass, setter comes out to the 10-foot line to set it. Back row. HPA, that's a good swing. Maybe got a little lucky on that play.
No, you know, the block, I think, took their took the angle, and he kind of chipped it down the line. He didn't look like he got his feet there, and he just hit for the court and, you know, made a nice swing at it.
Okay, we got a score of 3-2. HBA with the lead. We got number one, West Hatte. Jump set, serve. Great pass to the middle, short set. Boy, you get a good pass, you give the setter a dozen different options, don't you?
Yeah, you know what, great play by Ian Secura to come back. You know, after that first ball, he comes back and just makes a great pass, you know. Danny Glenn knows his players and knows that this kid can come to play, you know, and that he's going to be okay for him.
Looks like we got a wet spot on the court. So
I think there's some debris back in the back there. He doesn't want him, you know. Francis IU is a, you know, longtime head official, head of many sports. Yeah. And kind of the chairman or the president or head of the ILH Officials Association for Volleyball. And he's having to step in here. I think somebody didn't show it on their lines duty. So I don't think it's wet or anything. Well, we're tied here. You know, this is kind of people, they're kind of feeling themselves out a little bit, you know, and you're kind of seeing a little bit of, you know, who they're going to go to in the clutch, that type of thing. So,
all right, we got number 20.
Will Connolly, huh?
Will Connolly serving. Jump floater. Great pass to the middle. Set to the outside, double block.
Oh, what a play.
Great dig. Set to the outside, back set. Now another softie.
Oh,
what a... Two touches off the block, but couldn't come up with that one.
Yeah, and you know what? Just a great play on both sides. You saw a great defensive play on Newport Harbor, and then you saw Chris Matsui come in and swallow that free ball play and make a great pass out of it.
Good jump set. Overpass, this could be trouble.
You know, this is one of HBA's weapons that they have to be able to score points tonight in this match with Ryan Ryan Lung at the service box, and
that's,
you know,
right,
making a tough serve, making it tough on the sailors over there.
High throw, jump serve, they let it go out wide left. Let me ask you, when you say great serve and then a serve out, do we call it a wash? What does the coach say there? Because you want them to take a hard swing, but...
Yeah, but you don't want that kind of a thing. You've put these guys in jail by, you know, making a tough serve that, you know, and then just to give them a freebie, you know. And here again, you know, this is like one of those cardinal sins, you know, is that the other team has given you a gift and given you an opportunity to get back in the game, and then you go ahead and put it in the net. So it's kind of...
Sometimes hard to tell whether it's a mental error or a physical error, though, because they could actually do something wrong physically or... just not be concentrating, yeah?
I think it's more mental than physical.
All right, we got a rally here. Set to the outside, number 10. Good dig. It's going to take another swing on it. Gets it up, double
Cody,
hit.
Cody Caldwell with that put away. Yeah, the Sailors, they got a little mix-up there on serve receive. They had some little rotational communication malfunction.
We got Cody Caldwell back to serve for the Tars. Jump serve to the middle. Chris Matsui, perfect pass. Back set. Nice dig. Up to the middle. Miscommunication between the setter and Austin Bagby.
Yeah, you know, I like this kid Caldwell, boy. He's got some long arms. He attacks the ball well. He made a great dig there. And, you know, they didn't get the point, but I like the way he plays.
Got number 11, Chad Beretta, back to serve. Another jump serve. Pass, brings the setter out a little bit. Low set. Unreachable by Matsui. Matsui's out on the ground on just about every play. That's what we want from a libero, right?
Yeah. You know, he...
They don't stay clean, as we say.
No.
Right?
He plays every point to its fullest. He's really an exciting player to watch.
You got number 25, Jay Ordaz, back. Getting ready to launch a jump serve, looks like. To the middle, Matsui. Perfect pass again. Back set. Kind of paintbrushed that. Did you think that was a set that setter wanted there? Or?
You know, no. The location was no good, and it it kind of looked a little funny in the end product.
Did, right? Yeah.
But
another jump serve to the middle. Set to the outside. Let's see if they call a touch. We have no touch. So number 10, Michael Fisher, launches it out of bounds. We got timeout, HBA.
Yeah, you know, a couple things here. You know, you got West Hatai on HBA is, you know, right there. He had some good passes, and he's a brand new setter this year. He's been the libero in the past, and they're using him now as a setter. And you know, his location is not quite always there, and so the hitters are approaching in one way, and it's not where they think it's going to be, and so you have kind of a little bit of a misconnection and stuff. So. That's all right. You know, Tony wants to kind of keep things close here. I think it's a good call, an early timeout.
That's
given
right.
up three straight points. You know, you want to keep these guys, these big guys, close to you.
Right. How many timeouts does a team get during a match?
Two per game. Yeah, so.
So you use one early sometimes to kill the momentum of another team, yeah?
Yeah, you know, in this rally scoring era, you really need to be in control of the momentum. And if a team gets away from you early, boy, it's really hard to
this
reel them back in.
Really depends on momentum, I think. All right, number 25, Jay Ordaz, back. Jump serve. See if he can keep up his streak. Brings the setter out to the middle again. Back line hit to the go-to guy.
Another great dig here by Caldwell, too. You know, he took Ryan Leung's best shot and kind of popped it up. He's a player, boy. Yeah. You know, both teams are in this situation now where the setter's in the front row, and they've only got two hitters that are in the front row, and so they're kind of feeling each other out in these couple rotations here.
We got a tight set. Incredible dig by Chris Matsui. Teammate wasn't able to get it up. Boy, that kid can get his hands up or down.
Yeah.
Real quick, can he?
He's quick, and he, you know, like I said, he's exciting. You're going to see some great plays out of him tonight.
All right, we got number 12, Jackson Carmack, back to serve. Going to go with a floater. Just out, just wide left.
You know, this kid's a good setter. He's a good floor general. He's definitely spacing. Their game plan looks to me like, you know, they're going after the middle. They know that they got a mismatch against HBA's middle, and so they're going to attack it.
We're back to the first rotation with Matsui. A little jump floater to the middle. Can't get it over.
Yeah, the set looked a little low there, Chris. Yeah. You know, he didn't quite get it out of his hands quick enough.
Yeah, low contact point too, right?
Yeah.
Matsui back to serve again. See if he can spark a momentum shift here for the Eagles. Brings the setter out again. Great dig. Set up to number 9, Leung. Set to the middle. Again, another miscommunication.
Oh, opportunity right here.
There you go. Big opportunity. That's right what they want to be doing, right? Take advantage of any opportunity. You got the big hitter on the outside.
Well, you get an easy third ball comes over, you know, and you got Matsui back there passing, and you got Ryan Leung on the left going over this block. I mean, that's an automatic point.
Should be. That's right.
In most cases. I mean, that's a pretty potent combination right there. So.
You got Matsui back to serve again. 11-9, Eagles advantage. Good pass to the middle again. Great hit, even better dig. Leung, strong arm again. Set to the middle, 10-foot line.
Oh, and there's our guy Caldwell. You know, he makes a great dig, and he slid into the middle of the court to hit what we call a pipe out of the back row. They definitely wanted to go to him.
I don't think he had a block up against him, so
no,
it was
he didn't.
The right call by the setter.
Oh, yeah. This
just
setter
got a little
is
bit
good.
Off the net, jacked it up. Ooh, good serve.
There you can see, he called a different play. You know, he had his middle hitter number 20, Conley, coming in front of him. There he brought him behind him, got a little different look for HBA, and was successful.
You got Rusty Sario with the jump serve to the middle. Brings the setter out a little bit. Nice swing. Again, a miscommunication. Who should get that ball, Peter?
Yeah, well, if you got a libero that's on the court, I think he should be getting, he should be playing that. But technically, the off blocker, you know, he can make a play on that
as
well.
It's a classic, I got it,
yeah,
you get it sort of thing. Right? Jump serve to the back line, to the setter, to the outside. Ooh, good swing. Number six, Cody Caldwell with another kill.
That was a great play by them. You know, they got a good pass. The setter got the speed to the outside. You know, it was 13-11. Difficult for HBA to get to it, so
Eagles.
It was a good play.
Tars with some momentum right here. Back set, good set to Leung. Tipped off the block.
Did you say Tars? I thought they were the
Tars.
Sailors.
Well, we'll get to that story at the next time out, I bet.
Oh, all right.
Yes, they are the Sailors, but they're... Go by Tars also, we hear. Leung back to serve. Just drops the hammer on that serve. Setter comes up. Ugly set. Here we go. See if we can get something. Oof. All right, here we go. Regroup. Good swing. Unreachable. Well, it wasn't the prettiest rally of the night.
No.
But...
I'm sorry, but I couldn't help getting a chuckle out of some of those comments, you know. But yeah,
I call it like I see it, you know. We're not gonna pull any punches here tonight on Puna Vision. And we got another timeout.
Well, you got a burst here by Newport, you know. Now you got a burst by HBA, and it's pretty much coming down to Chris, you know, which team is serving and passing better,
right.
You know. One team serves in one rotation real well, and the other team doesn't pass. Boom, you know, it's 2 or 3 points in a run there. So,
right, we're noticing that the Newport setter is just in a better position to set the ball each time, which obviously comes from a better pass, which is usually going to determine a lot of points on the board.
Yeah, and he's had a little bit more seasoning, I think, than the HBA setter. You know, he... When the pass isn't quite there, his location is still pretty good.
Right.
You know, but HBA, give him credit. You know, HBA's hitters, they're swinging for the court. When something's not quite there, they're putting the ball in the court and giving themselves a chance to play defense, because their bread and butter is their defense. You know, that's a strength of their game, so.
All right, we got Ryan Leung back to serve again. Boys, he throw it up high when he puts in that jump serve. Going to take a little off. Brings the setter way out to the line. Beautiful.
Oh, a little off-speed.
Beautiful off-speed shot.
Yeah, and you know, that's not something you want your top dog doing out of a timeout, but you know, he definitely saw the defense was back and gave him a little roll shot.
Yeah, Connor Curry back to serve. Outstanding pass. Brings it to Ryan Leung.
Yeah, that's kind of what we call a B set. It's not in the middle of the court. It's kind of a little bit more to the left part of the court. And kind of.
It's the kind of set that gives a great player a lot of options.
Yeah, it sure does. Sure does.
All right, we got a Tyler Hudson coming in to serve. Great pass to the middle, lots of options.
Oh, good effort, good effort.
Another successful quick set.
Great play
Newport.
By Newport. The first time through, they had problems in that rotation. And, I'm sorry, you Newport fans back there. But Jackson Carmack, what a great sight on his part to see, you know, that make the adjustment, get the ball to the middle guy. They need Conley putting that ball in the court.
Yep, 17-13, Eagles lead.
Sorry, that was
got
Caldwell.
11. Chad Beretta. Oh, great pass again to the middle.
Great play. Great play. Austin
Newport
Bagby.
Harbor is really mixing it up to their hitters, aren't they?
Yeah, and when the pass is there, they really want to go to the middle. They want to establish that and keep establishing that, because they know that's a mismatch
the
for them.
Key to any offense is really giving that setter lots of options.
Yeah.
Jay Ordaz with the jump pass. Off the net.
See, there again, the location was too far outside.
Yeah.
Pass was kind of off. Location was a little too far outside, and the hitter didn't get his feet to the ball.
Exactly. Doesn't even get a chance to jump on it. All right, we got Jay Ordaz with another jump serve. Great.
Oh,
great,
they got a
play
break
by
there.
Matsui. Out by about 8 inches, it looked like. It's a great call by him. Oh, we got some substitutions going on here. Got number 13, Austin Bagby, coming out. Libero Ian Sequeira coming into the game. Ryan Sugihara with the serve. Pass to the front.
Oh, he missed
down
that.
Down the line, out.
Yeah, and you know what? He doesn't need to cut that close. That blocker out there is not a real big blocker. The setter did a great job of isolating him one-on-one on the outside. He just needs to hit the big part of the court on that one.
Sugihara back to serve again with the floater. Good pass to the middle. Again.
There you go.
Yeah. I really like it when a setter shows confidence in a hitter. You know, guy hits it out, setter goes right back to him. I love that.
It's a great play. Great play on all accounts. You're giving everybody the confidence knowing that, hey, I made a mistake, but I'm
spreading the love, as we say, right? Jackson Carmack back with the serve.
Yeah.
Net serve, still good. Jump. Quick
Here's
set.
Here's a great play by Jackson Carmack here to serve Ryan Lung short,
right.
Pull him out of the passing pattern so they can't, you know, they can't get him
pull
the ball
him
as
out
a
of
hitter.
Position.
Yeah.
Again,
see,
look
doing
at that.
It again.
Very smart. Oh, very smart. Man. Oh, just outside.
Tactically, a great, great play.
I bet Ryan's going to get a lot of those this year.
I would think so.
Yeah.
I would think so.
All right, we got Chris Matsui back to serve again. 20-17, Eagle lead. Perfect pass to the middle. Quick set. Good block. Libero set. 10-foot line. Long. Eagles with some good momentum.
Yeah, they do. You know, they're playing good defense. They're keeping the ball in the court. They're kind of waiting for Newport to, you know, to hit the ball out, which is what they are, you know, which is what they're doing. They're not playing what we call ball control volleyball right now. They're hitting balls out, they're serving balls out. Their passing is fine. You know, the setter's getting the ball to who he needs to get it to, and they just need to put the ball in the court.
And Dan Glenn looks like he's trying to light a fire under his team, showing some passion.
Yeah, he doesn't look like he's a real happy camper right now.
You
give away cheap points like that, you know, it's...
Yeah, we talked to him before the game. He was a real mellow fellow. Now, different circumstances.
He's a fiery guy. You know, he expects his boys to come and play a smart game of volleyball that involves, you know, serving the ball in the court, hitting the ball in the court, and not giving the other team some cheap points. So.
21-17, you're still in it. You got to play this out. You can still come back easily with a little momentum shift. Matsui with the serve. Again, another great pass to the middle.
Great
Quick
play.
Quick set, spike.
Great play.
Unreachable.
You know, this kid Carmack, he's staying with the game plan. It's definitely A. Just keep feeding the middle, yeah. You know.
All right, we got number 11, Rusty Sari, back with the jump serve. Good serve, good pass, brings the setter out a little far. Ryan Lung, wide. Took a good swing on it.
Yeah, he sure did. You know, but he doesn't need to cut it that close. Right. You know, you're up 21-18. You know, you got two guys maxing on you.
Sari back with the serve. Ooh, great pass. Lots of options again to Ryan. Great kill.
You know what I'm interested to see here, Chris, and I didn't really know it. 21-18, he hits that ball out. Is okay. They're ahead like they were last night. You know, how are they going to do with a lead tonight? You know, and
right.
Can they hold on to it against, you know, the bigger California team? So we'll see.
West Hate with the jump serve.
Great
to the
pass.
Middle, another quick serve.
Great
set.
Pass.
Like
Matsui's
said,
got it.
Great effort by Matsui. Like you said, they're pounding the middle.
Right. Great pass there. You know, the sign of a great player is that, you know, when the chips are down, the end of the game is tight like this, you know, can you come up with the pass that you need? Holy cow, that was a great pass.
Got number 20, Will Connolly back to serve. 22-20, Eagle lead. Floater, great pass. Set to the outside, number 11. Can't get it over the net.
Oh, he just tried to cut that too close. I mean, he's got a big block there. You know, I don't know that he should be cutting that thing that close, you know.
Teo Bray takes his last time out of the game. Good time to take it.
You know, I like it at that point. You know, you're basically keeping the other team down. You're not letting them get even with you. You know, you see Newport Harbor's coming out early here. Some of their fans, you can see that they're here supporting them. They're a little concerned, but, you know, I don't think they should be. You know, I think right now it favors the Sailors here.
Right.
You got Caldwell, who's, you know, middle front. You got Ryan Lung here, who's ready to rotate to the back. I think it's, you know, advantage to the Sailors here.
Absolutely, with that rotation
coming
up that they won't want to be in. Okay, we got number 20, Will Connolly, back to serve, jump floater. Good serve, bring the setter out. Going to go out to the outside, number 11.
Now that's the hit.
That's what they wanted.
That's the one he should have, you know. He went to school, you know, and I'm sure Tony said to him, hey, brother, you don't need to cut that thing that close. Just hit the high hands.
And again, you got the setter going to Chad Beretta, showing confidence in his guy.
Yeah.
Once again,
going
we like that.
Back to him, especially out of a timeout, you know.
We got number 11, Rusty Sari, coming into the game for the Tars. We got the big gun serving for the Eagles here, Ryan. This kid's dropped the hammer a couple times. Let's see if he can do it again. Jump serve to the back row. Set to the outside.
Oh, we got a touch,
though.
We got an out call.
But I believe we have a touch call.
The lineman called it.
Teo Bray is interested in this call.
Yeah, he called.
And we have a definite
touch. I didn't.
Point Tars. It's a big call.
It's a huge call. I mean, it goes, you know, you're 24-21 instead of 23-22.
That's right.
Yeah.
The right guy made the right call on that one, I believe. Number five, Connor Curry with the serve.
Oh, you can't
serves it out.
That.
Big mistake there, right?
Big mistake. You got a gift there. I mean, it was arguable whether it was a touch, but you know the linesman didn't hesitate. I mean, he called it immediately when the play happened. So he saw something, and he's a seasoned official.
We got number six, Tyler Hodson, back for the game. Floater. Setter had to run for it. Rusty Sari with the spike.
Oh, what a dig!
Good dig. See if they can kill it. They did it. Well, a disappointed Newport loses a close one to the HBA Eagles.
Yeah, but you know what? I think that they're going to regroup. They did some things where they gave up a few points, and to HBA's credit, you know, they battled, and they when they were ahead, it was an opportunity for them to kind of learn from a mistake that they made yesterday, and they came through on it, you know, so credit goes to them and Tione and his staff, but I think you're going to see Newport Harbor come out with a little bit more kind of maybe focus, you know, commitment to, you know, pass ball and serve ball in the court and kind of make some, Daniel make some adjustments. He may kind of shift his rotation and, you know, see how that goes.
Well, I'd expect them to continue to pound that middle, take advantage of some of that size.
Very much
difference.
So. I mean, they're very successful in the middle. You know, they're outside guys, couple key points. The setter got them one-on-one, and, you know, they're hitting the ball down the line and out, you know, or kind of trying to hit it too sharp in the angle. But
that's right. We saw a lot of kills in the middle, and I don't recall a lot of kills from that left side on Newport.
Not too many. You know, they didn't get too much.
If they're going to set them, they definitely need those kills on the left side.
Well, I, you know, watching this kid, Rusty Sari, in warm-ups, you know, I think he's a better player than what he's shown here tonight. You know, last night I checked the stats, and he hit a negative 0-9, which, you know, Danny Glenn tells me that, you know, was very uncharacteristic of him. So I think that, you know, we're going to see a different kid in the second game here. At least I think that from Danny's perspective, I think he hopes to see, you know, something better. And you know, you Tars fans back home, I hope you see something better too, you know, because you definitely need
Eagles
him to
side?
Get on track.
Do you think
track.
O'Bray is asking his team to make some adjustments?
No, I don't think so. I think that, you know, he needs to maybe get a little better passing out of his freshman, Michael Fisher. You know, he probably needs his setter to set a little bit more to Michael Fisher. You know, Beretta's had some sets and kind of hasn't really gotten his feet to him and made a couple of errors and he saved his setter, but I think he needs to make sure he spreads it out to those two guys. Last night they went a little bit too much to Ryan, and they need to be able to depend on those three guys to kind of get their kills and play the ball.
Do you think at some point we might see a triple block on Ryan?
I think that's possible. I don't know that you know, the Sailors will bring that if that's in their repertoire. I know, you know, Danny Glenn's coaching, I know that's a reality. So, yeah, there's certain
situations.
That seems
to be one of those Larry Bird situations where everybody in the gym knows who it's going to, and they still go to him, right?
Yeah. Michael's going to take the final shot, no matter, you know, everybody That's knows. Right. Larry's going to take it, yep. you know, and Ryan's going to get that set.
Ryan's in the front, he's getting the set when it comes down to it. So
you know, they've got their offense set that even if he's in the back, they're going to run a play, you right. know, from him. They call
they
the timeout.
They weren't afraid to do that.
And he brought it out of the timeout. So looks like all the same players. I think he's in a different rotation, though. Looks to me like he might be starting. No, I think he's starting in rotation one, where he started last time. Yeah, same rotation.
Well, so, we saw a good mix of serves, jump serves, and floaters. Do you have a preference yourself?
You know, I don't. I think that each player should have more than one serve, because you're going to come to the gym some nights and it's not going to be your A serve that's not going to be on. You got to be able to go to your B serve and certain times and keep that ball in. Ryan did that, you know, in the game one.
Yeah, number four, Ren Sugihara back to serve for the Eagles. Started the second game. Set to the left side. Number six, Cody Caldwell stuffs it in a double block.
Yeah, you know, this Carmack, he really likes to go to this kid. When they need a play, you know, he goes to this kid, Cody. So, and he delivers.
Number 11, Rusty Starry back for the jump serve again. If you score another point, great serve, even better pass. Set to Ryan. Oh, my goodness.
Holy cow.
I think we're both speechless on that one.
Well, he definitely found the hole in the block. I'm not certain if he went over, but he found the hole, and, you know.
Well, he bounced that. All right, we got Chris Matsui back to serve. Going to go with the jump floater. Set to the outside. Pass. Brings the setter way out. Back to Ryan. Great back pass. Let's see.
You know,
Chris, that was a great set.
Interesting. You notice an adjustment here that Danny Glenn made, that both of the HBA's first two servers were float serve. Both of the Newport Harbor kids took the ball with their hands. I think that's a real aggressive move. It's, you know, if you're going to float serve, we're going to take it with our hands. We're going to make a good aggressive play on the ball. And we're going to get things rolling.
Jay Ordaz back with the jump serve. Matsui with his hands. Back to Leong, the go-to guy. Going to launch a big set here to the outside. Good swing. Great pass. Great dig. Ooh, Ryan hits the bad set. Not Ryan's fault. Hit the antenna.
Yeah, you definitely notice that, you know, he moves a little, the setter moves a little off and whatnot. His location kind of drops a little bit, so.
J.R. Daz with another over. Let's see if this goes down. Yeah, we got a net call. That was Chris Matsui's fault, not West Hatai's fault. Chris Matsui with the overpass.
Well, you can see the body language of the Sailors here. They're coming out a little bit more aggressive.
They're coming out.
They're kind of stepping the tempo up a little bit.
Ordaz with another serve. There it is. That's the one you want to the big hitter. All right, here we go. Set to the middle.
Ooh, they ran a double quick there, huh?
We got some confusion on the Eagles side. We got another free ball. Dan Glenn jumping off the bench on that one. That was upsetting.
Yeah, you know, that's a freebie.
Balls.
I mean, you know, you're looking at a difference. That's a difference of 5-1 and 4-2. Yeah. You know, they make that pass, and boom, they run the middle, and you know, they got a four-point swing, and they still got the momentum. HBA's on their heels. So,
all right, we got West Hatay back to serve. Great serve. Sends the setter out for pass. Great dig by Matsui. Double block effective for the Tars. Up to Ryan, can't get it over.
Bad set. You know, I mean, here he is setting him all the way here. That's a really hard ball to hit. Yeah. So it's an even harder ball to set. It's just misplay. Yeah. Misplay.
Hammer jump serve.
That's a back row play.
Well, that started with a great serve. Yeah. So he almost got a good pass off that, but I think he didn't account for the velocity of that ball.
Yeah. Well, you know, this kid, Cody Caldwell, I can't say enough about him. I mean, he's definitely their rock. You know, he's come to play. He's kind of accounting for a lot of their side outs, their points, and now he's serving here. You know, if they don't have that one mishap, that free ball play, I mean, we're looking at 8-1 instead of 6-2. And
well, what adjustments do you think Obrey's making here?
they need to talk and set up their serve receive pattern. They're not handling the Newport Harbor's serve right now in the early parts of this game. They need to get Matsui, move his feet, talk to Ryan, get his, you know, who's passing which area, and get them a pass. Because when they're passing, their offense runs pretty smoothly. So.
And like we've said before, and we'll probably say 100 more times tonight, give that setter options, right? Get that pass.
Yeah.
Give that setter options. You could just put that on a loop.
You'll hear me say it time and again tonight. You know, you got to win the serving passing battle. Right now, Newport Harbor's winning.
Jump
serve.
So
here again, we got a free ball here.
Let's see
what happens.
Put this away. Wow.
Little step out play there.
Step out play. Another free ball. Let's see if they can put this away. Outside to number one, and they do. It's a single block. Take advantage of that single block.
Yeah, you know, and they cleaned up their free ball. Right there, they've had three opportunities, and they had two great ones, and, you know, they've kind of made a change.
Cody Caldwell again with the serve. Matsui brings the setter out a little further than he probably wanted to. Did Leong. Great hit.
This kid's got range. I mean, that thing's at the 3-meter line. He's a front row player, and that thing, he's hitting that thing 10 feet off the net, and the angle that he's putting that on, you know, the other team's 11-foot line. Wow.
That's impressive.
So very impressive.
Leong back to serve. Throws it up. Just about hits the ceiling when he throws it up. Drops the hammer. Great pass. Set to the outside.
Oh, my.
We got an in call.
Oh, my. That is a great hit by Zach Martin. That thing is just to the big part of the court.
And had the high contact point, great approach.
Yeah.
Great set. All comes back to the great pass by Rusty Sari.
You know, he only got two sets last night and put one away. So, you know,
Connor
maybe.
Curry back to serve. Matsui with a great dig. Great double block. Looked like number 20. Will Connolly will get credited. At least he's taking credit for the block. Is that how we do the stats?
Well, you know, one of the great things is that you get a block, turn around and let the rest of your team celebrate. I mean, right. You need anything to get this match even at 1-1. So
Curry back with the jump serve again. Matsui brings the setter way out. Ryan Leong, free ball. Quick set to the middle. Mm.
You know what? I like the play, though.
Yeah.
I like the play. I like the choice. You know, the execution wasn't quite there.
He had a wide open swing. You just got to get a higher contact point, so probably a better set is needed.
Yeah, yeah. But just a great choice. I like that.
Hodson back with the serve. Great pass to the middle.
Oof. Hey, that's a good swing.
Got a net call, I believe.
Yeah, but
Eagles.
Just a great swing by this kid, Rusty Sari.
And I tell you, he's got quite the vertical.
he sure does.
Just about jumping over that net. All right, we got a floater. Use of the hands. Quick set to the middle. Blocked. Coming out to Sari. Ah, mental error.
Total mental.
Got to put that in play.
He needs to give his. They got the momentum. Just put the ball in the court. And
well, you're not going to kill that.
No.
All you can hope for is to put it probably to the back row to make him pass at some distance. Jump serve, wide left.
You know, Chris, when the set isn't there as coaches, one of the things we talk about is, hey, hit a zero. Just put the ball on the court. Give us a chance to play defense. And right now, things are going Newport Harbor's way. Give us a chance to play defense. You know, great serve here by Carmack. Guy, you know, this kid is really leading his team well.
Let's see if he goes to the same spot. Another floater, Ryan Leong. He's going to take another swing. Takes a good swing to Sari. Gets it up.
Too bad. Way to scramble, though. Yeah, you know, you're going to start to see them serve Ryan a little bit more. I think, Ryan didn't pass a whole lot of balls last year. And you want to make him do more than just hit the ball. So we may see more of that tonight.
12-6. Pass to the middle. They go. Ooh, boy, that some good play action on that play.
Yeah, you see a little different tempo there. You know, they're bring Caldwell in on what we call a little X1 play. You know,
right. They definitely got the blockers to bite on that first play. Sari back to serve. Good jump serve spinner there. Out to Ryan. Off the block again.
You know, that's a great set by West to tie. He ran that thing, had to bump it, just played it safe. made a good conservative set and just gave Ryan something to swing at. You know, the difference right now in this match is that HBA is passing away. You got Chris Matsui back to serve here. We'll see what Newport does with his serve here.
Set to the outside. Ooh, launched it. Just mishit, yeah?
Yeah.
He set just, was there, pass was there.
It looked like he just tried to do too much with it, yeah. You know? See if Newport takes his serve with their hands.
There you do.
Yep.
Good call, Peter. Didn't matter much, but...
And you got Caldwell hitting a quick there. He passed his own serve.
Right.
See what
up.
Happens when you got a float serve like that. You can be aggressive with your hands and then come in and attack. God, they sent him out of the middle of that. He's been hitting nothing but outside. Boy, this offense is really good by Newport Harbor.
You can't be slow and do that either. You got to have quick feet to get up to that net to get that. All right, over. Going to take a good swing on it. Yep. Will Connolly gets it put on a tee for him. Takes advantage. 15-8 now. Seeing a much different game this time.
That's a mental error there, Chris. You know, HBA, you got him on the ropes. HBA's only got two hitters in the front row. You know, it's a weak rotation for him. You got a good rotation for yourself. You want to keep that in, you know, and then you put Wes Hatai, who's a pretty good server, on the back row here.
Got Zach Martin, or sorry, Wes Hatai serving.
Yeah.
Yep. Oof, taking the hard angle.
Oh, I like that swing, though. You know, I think that he didn't need to cut it that close, but that's definitely a spot that he wants to go
great
to.
Great set, great pass. West Altai back to serve again. Let's see if the Eagles can pick up some momentum. Get some more points on the board for them. Jump serve to the back. Great serve. Great pass by Rusty Sari. Diver in the middle.
Oh, pancake.
Called out. No touch.
Yeah, what a great dig by Chris Matsui. And the location that set just kind of was too tight. It drifted too tight, and the sailors were smart enough to pull their hands back.
Using that mythical pancake maneuver. Set to the outside. Block. I don't think they got it. Yeah, no touch. Four hits. Oh.
You know, they got to get that kid on track. If they want to get back in this match and in games three and four, they got to get this kid on track. Ooh, they're bringing in another setter.
Well,
either not happy with the location or trying to get something else
jump
going.
Jump serve, overpass, free ball for the Tars.
See what they do
out
with
to
it.
The outside. Yep.
Great swing.
Well, it looked like that setter had four options on that play, didn't he?
Yeah, it sure did. You know, this Zach Martin, I like the way he swings. You know, he's hit nothing but the back corners, the lying deep corner, and he hit another one in the far corner in the cross court. He's a player.
Great serve.
Oh, what a serve.
That's tough. You want your libero to get it, but he can't cover the whole court, can he?
No.
He could cover, I guess, the entire court except the lines.
Yeah.
If it's going to hit the line, one of the guys on the outside has to
Matsui's
get it.
Matsui's good, but he's not that good. Oh, he's made an adjustment over here. We'll see what happens.
All right.
Yeah, he took that play away from him. He made an adjustment. He moved over where Caldwell had served that ball and forced Caldwell to serve a different area. That's a smart play by him.
Ryan going to try and hammer some points for the Eagles. Jump serve. Great serve. Great pass.
Oh, my. What a play.
Got Matsui with the bump set. Great spike by the Eagles there. Number six, Cody Caldwell, unable to come up with the dig. Matsui coming in with the bump.
Yeah.
The bump set.
Well, you know, if the ball's in front of the 3-meter line, he's got a bump set. He's got to handle that as a bump. You know,
great. Dropping the hammer on that serve.
Uh-oh. We got a miscommunication there.
Yeah. Going out for that step out.
Yeah.
I thought he was coming up for a quick one.
Yeah, and you know what?
The hitter thought he was going behind him for the step out.
It's kind of one of those things where, you know, he's had a great match so far, Jackson Carmack, but he's got to make sure that guy knows that. I mean, he's handling that ball and that he can't be having that guy go behind when he wants him in front.
Leong with another great serve. 10-foot line. Matsui with the pass.
Yeah, but that's his guy.
The dig. Yeah.
You know, he needs it. Carmack needed a side out. He goes right to Caldwell. You know, he definitely knows, hey, we need to win this game and get back in the match, and Caldwell's going to take us there.
That's right. We got Connor Curry back to serve with the jumper. Out.
You know, we got a new middle blocker here. We got John Macbeth is in here in the front row for Newport Harbor.
So I feel the momentum's on the Eagles side right now. They've had a string of serves, and let's see if they can convert on this momentum.
Not if they do that. Yeah. You know, there again, it's, you know, we talked about, you know, ball control. You know, it's not only serving, not only passing and hitting the ball in the court, but you got to serve the ball in the court, especially in key situations. Here we got Conley coming in to serve for Macbeth. You know, they just subbed him in, try to get him some front row time, that type of thing.
Nice floater to the middle. Set to the outside. Now, four hits.
Yeah, you know, I think Coach Tione, he's got Michael Fisher down on the side. He's trying to, you know, probably settle him down. You know, he's a freshman, but he needs that kid in the game.
Another floater. Pass by Leong to the middle. Great dig. Great spike, too.
Oh, what a play.
Another set to the outside for the Eagles. Out, and we have no touch call.
Great dig point by this scores. Max Richley. Golly. Here the kid sat on the bench for a game and a half. He comes in, makes a great serve.
Max
Here he
Richley
goes again.
Another floater. Again, going to the middle, but we might.
You know, I think HBA is just trying anything. You know, they had a great pass. They're trying to get something going. They've been sputtering this game, and they're trying.
Got number 14, Kevin Rickshaw, coming into the game.
Yeah, I think Denny Glenn's trying to get some of his guys some playing time. Well,
there we go. Set to the outside. Block. Movement
ball's
on the
outside
antenna.
The antenna. Point to Newport.
Point to Newport.
Yeah.
Boy, that's got to be a disappointing second game for Obrey.
Yeah, you know, They just kind of, they didn't stay focused on what their game plan was. Their game plan in the beginning was to come out, pass well, play great defense, you know, hit the ball in the court. And here they, to Newport Harbor's credit, they came out and they knew, hey, you know, we talked about Danny Glenn saying, hey, they need to serve the ball in the court. They came out and they served tough. I don't think they had a service error, maybe one service error that game. And
coupled on the poor passing by the Eagles. You can't have the setter running out to the 10, 12-foot line every time to make that. I mean, just not a recipe for success.
Well, what it does, you know, from a defensive standpoint, it takes away some of the hitters. So then the defense can just isolate on Ryan Long on the outside or Chad Beretta. And so they're getting two blockers up. And, you know, as a result, you're getting I think, three blocks at that game.
Right. And
know,
that,
which
that
is
good
high.
Passing that the Newport Harbor team takes advantage of. Their setter could basically sit on a bar stool, it looks like, and just dish it out to three or four different options.
And to his credit, he's staying with the game plan. You know, so we're going to set the middle, we're going to keep setting the middle, and we're going to set Caldwell. Caldwell's going to get his swings, and he's going to be our go-to guy.
And until the Eagles establish that they can stop that play, just keep going to it, huh?
Yeah, and you know what? Showing some versatility on his part. You know, here he's hitting left side the whole first game. Second game here, he's passing the ball, hitting quick. He's hitting a combination play out of the back row on another play. I mean, he's doing it all for him offensively, you know, and I think what he's allowing the other guys to do is the opportunity to get themselves in the flow of the game. You know, you're starting to see Rusty Sari starting to kind of hit more positive. You're seeing Zach Martin, who's, you know, he's getting a few more sets tonight. He's putting the ball in the corner. You know, so they got to just keep doing what they did in that game. You know, play the percentage game that I think that, you know, Danny Glenn has kind of coached them to.
Well, it sounds like we have conflicting strategies, too, because for Newport, it's spread the love. Get it to everyone, but for the Eagles, they've got a go-to guy, don't they?
They got to go to Ryan. They got to make sure that Ryan's, you know, he's getting some more sets. They've also got to make sure that, you know, they got to make an adjustment here that Ryan has. He's got to pass the ball. I mean, Newport Harbor has shown that, hey, we're going to serve you a little bit here, big boy. You know, we're going to make you have to pass
and
the ball.
And that's great coaching, right?
Oh, that is great coaching. You make an adjustment. So we'll see. You know, I think Tione is a great coach, and we'll see what kind of adjustment that HBA is going to make here.
Now, is there a way to shield Ryan so he does not have to do that passing job?
Very much so. You just kind of you push him over into the, you know, kind of the side of the court. You give him less area. You can have him take a couple of steps forward. especially when he's in the front row. You know, put him front in the line, move him closer to the net. If he's in the back row and you want him, you know, attacking out of the back row, you're going to have to kind of pinch him a little bit more. You know, they don't want to put him, you know, on the back line, but right. They may have to. So
yeah.
We'll see. Looks like they're going to start in the same rotation. Both teams start in the same rotation. HBA is in rotation five, we call that. You know, the setter is kind of in the fifth position coming around.
Well, if we had a momentum meter, it'd definitely be towards Newport Harbor right now.
Definitely. We'll see. Right here, you know, you got Jackson Carmen. We'll see what kind of serve he gets right out of the chute here.
Back with the floater. Matsui to the middle. Out to Ryan. Gets a good swing outside.
Yeah.
I don't think that's where they wanted the set to be.
No, that was, you know, that's his lack of experience. You know, it was a great pass, and he just kind of mishandled the set, you know. So.
Oh, he got Carmack back to serve again to Matsui. Bad pass again to the middle. Newport gets their hands on it. Good set to Sari. Gets his hands on it, and we got kill.
Yeah, and there you go. You know, Caldwell making the dig. You know, the kid's everywhere. He's hitting the ball. He's digging the ball. You know, and they're sticking him. He's coming out of the rotation out here to block Ryan Lung, HBA's big boy. So
Carmack with the serve. Great pass to the middle. Oof.
Yeah, holy cow.
Nowhere to go on that one.
No, it's not. And I think it's a good, you know, they need to try it. Unfortunately, you know, the pass was left of center. Here you got a new setter coming in.
Cody Caldwell looked like he got all that block.
Well, they brought it right into his zone, and yep. He just maxed out on it.
Matsui with the pass. Set to the outside to Ryan again. Just not getting the sets that he wants.
Too bad.
Got an out call, no touch.
Great play, though. It's a great opportunity to get, you know, Austin Bagby, get him in the flow of it. You know, I like going to the middle and transitioning that, you know, keeping the momentum. I think that's a good call.
Matsui back. Down 2 points.
Nice Sorry pass. Nice pass.
That's a great kill.
Great play. Caldwell gets some momentum back for him again. You know, I notice here that Matsui, he's getting his feet anchored a little bit. He's not quite getting all the way to the ball in his serve-receive passing, and he's having a little bit of trouble with handling the ball.
Yeah,
a little surprised.
Newport really needs to take advantage of the size that they got, size difference they have at the front. Set to Ryan Lung.
Oh, too bad. Too bad.
You know, call a double on that, yeah?
Yeah, but you know what? I don't think that's a double. I thought that was a pretty good set. I think that he called pretty much on his body language.
Yeah.
It was kind of a little goofy, but I didn't think it was a throw.
Set to the outside. Great block by HBO.
Holy cow.
Number 11, Chad Beretta. Fantastic block.
Here's an interesting rotation here that Newport has here. You notice that Caldwell, he's passing right in the middle of the court here. You know, they want him to swing kind of one of two ways. There he's going the front.
Through the front.
Boom, what a play here.
There's that. Two quick sets on either side of him.
And there's that play that we saw in game two, you know, where he's passing the ball and then hitting it off of that. So
Jay Ordaz back for the jump serve. 5-3. Newport ahead. Pass to Ryan. Right what they wanted to do. Great set. Let's see if they can convert. Now Ryan launches it outside. Look, he's still looking for that touch call. Doesn't get it.
Yeah. No, it's a great play. You know, Newport, they're serving him. They're going after him.
Yep.
No matter where he is.
Ordaz back again. Matsui to the middle. Let's see what they do. Yeah. Overpass again. Boy, HBA really has got to get their passing down if they're going to make a play at this match.
They do, you know, and in the Newport's credit, they're, you know, the way you keep a team down like this is you just keep serving the ball in the court.
Right.
You notice these guys are taking a little something off it. They're not quite bombing it, and it's effective.
Back with another jump serve to Matsui again, getting him to go outside, brings the setter out to their go-to guy, Ryan.
Great dig. Great play by Caldwell. You can tell this kid's played some beach up in Southern California.
Yeah, rolling it over the block like that.
Down at 52nd Street or something like that. You know, he's got a little roll shot there.
Jay Ordaz back again. This kid's going to get tired jump serving. Matsui, good pass. Set to the outside. Number 11, Beretta. Set to.
Oh, that's a great swing.
Out of bounds. Oh, this is going into the stands and coming back into play.
Free ball here. We'll see what happens.
Again.
Little double quick that time. You know, so Newport showed a double quick where they both go in the front, and now they get a double quick where one's in the back, one's in the front. You know, here again, Caldwell's a terminator. This kid knows how to terminate, man.
Timeout, HBA. Good time for a timeout, I think, before things get out of control.
Yeah, it's maybe, you know, this is second, isn't it, this game already. You know, so he's going to have to make some adjustments here. You know, he's going to have to slow the game down with time substitutions and whatnot. You know, Danny Glenn, to his credit, his kids are playing the volleyball. I think he's coached them to, you know, taught them to play back in California. So.
Oh, and he is a teacher. He's had quite a string of successful volleyball players come out of both the boys and girls program out of Newport Harbor, hasn't he?
Oh, he sure has. You know, as a matter of fact, they talked about last night the fact that he had one of our Puno boys.
That's right.
Hugh Foster.
So, that's right. We were talking to him before the game. He only says a quarter alum because you only went to that school for 1 year, right?
You're right.
Three quarters Punahou, one right, quarter Newport
right,
Harbor.
Right. And he's got a bunch of kids that are playing college ball right now. You know, he's got one at Pepperdine, he's got a couple at UCLA, and you know, so they're perennial powers.
Ordaz back to serve again. Matsui.
Yeah. Oh man, that's a huge point right there.
First of all, we were real high on Matsui's passing at the beginning of the match, but
You know, he's just not quite getting there. That ball, you know, and he took something off of it. Newport kid took something off of it. But what a break for the HBA Eagles here. That should have been, you know, they get 10-3, ball's hitting the net, and they get a net call. Holy cow.
Leong with the serve. Good serve. Ooh, interesting set there. Not sure what you call that. Overset. Let's see if he can spike it. Yeah.
Oh.
John Macbeth.
Yeah.
John Macbeth. And he's
just come off the bench here.
Off the bench, and they're excited for this young man.
Oh, boy. You can tell he's excited about that.
Look at the smile on his face.
It's like, hey, Mom, look at me. I just got a kill out of that, Mom.
Ooh, great serve. Boy, he snapped that one, didn't he?
You know, this is turned into the Cody Caldwell show, you know?
Newport Harbor's having a good time now. Let's see if they can keep it up.
Ah, this kid's coming back next year, too.
Serve to Ryan. Take him out of the equation. He had a touch.
There's the Fisher hit. That's the one I've been waiting for. You know, in the high, deep corner. You know, I noticed, though, that West Hatai and his inexperience as a setter, he's not getting himself squared off to the hitters. And so a lot of his sets are drifting off the net, giving his hitters a difficult time.
Hodgson back to serve the jumper. Receives it with his hands, set to the outside. Good block by HBA, get their hands on it. Good set. Great dig by Sari. Free ball coming up. Let's see if HBA can convert. Set to the outside. Again.
Yeah.
The block was there, but a better swing.
Yeah, you know, this Fisher, I think maybe Choney told him, hey, brother, you got to come in and just start banging for the court here, you know? You're on the varsity now, you know? You gotta play like a varsity kid, you know?
That's right. Here comes Hodgson with another floater. Taken by the hands, 10 foot to Sari. Yeah. Not where you wanted that set. Sari had to approach it with
his left. You know,
it
looked like he was rushing him a little bit. Yeah. Looked a little low to me. Wasn't quite ready to swing at it here. So
a little momentum for the Eagles here.
Yeah, starting to make a little turn here.
Let's see if they can capitalize. Floater again. Another great floater to the back line. Wide open.
You know, I like this kid. Yeah. This Zach Martin. I keep talking about him. You know, he hits the ball in the court. You know, I think he's got 3 kills, 4 kills here, 6 attempts, something like that.
Good little run by the Eagles. Let's see if they can have a defensive stop here.
Five here. Connor Curry going to Penn State next year.
Yeah. Ryan.
Holy cow.
Approach. Boy,
what an angle.
Point. Great angle.
Golly, there's not many teams that are going to defend that.
No.
You know, if I'm Tioni, I'm telling his kids, hey, let's catch these guys at 20. I mean, their goal needs to be that they just chip away and try to catch them at 20.
Beretta back with the serve, serves it out.
It's not going to happen with plays like that.
Yeah. Equivalent of walking a batter in baseball, I would imagine. Free base, right?
Well, it's probably the equivalent of walking it when the bases are loaded.
Yeah, that's right.
You're walking in a run. You know, that's a point.
Siqueira with the serve. Outside, HBA. Good dig with the hands. Rusty Sorry coming up. Gets a good swing on off a bad set. Ryan Leong, and no touch.
You know, he looks like he's a little bit gun-shy. He's not quite sure that the location's going to be where he wants it to be. And, you know, he didn't kind of attack that like he's been attacking other stuff.
All right, timeout.
Oh, HBA. I guess I was wrong on that. He hadn't taken one. I was thinking of the other game. This is his second timeout. We're at 14-8 of this game. There's a lot of volleyball to play in this game. You know, two timeouts already. So he's going to have to slow the momentum down. You see him talking to his players here.
You think Glenn's making an adjustment here?
I don't think he's making. I think he's, you know, encouraging his kids. Hey, you're doing a good job. You know, stay with our game plan. I think Tioni's telling his guys, hey, look, we got to make an adjustment here. Move our feet. Be a little more aggressive passing. We got to be a little bit more aggressive attacking the ball. Get in there and cover our guys. But let's swing at the court. You know, if you swing at the net, the ball doesn't clear the net. You're not even giving us a chance to play to cover you. So.
And the Eagles have shown. At least two other players besides Leon they're willing to go to at this point.
Here you see Juliana Behrens, you know, one of the stars of the girls' team. And
heading off to Cincinnati, I believe.
University of Cincinnati, Reed Sunohara, the head coach there.
Set to the outside.
Much better play. Oh, great dig.
Free ball. Let's see if they can set up another great play. Great pass to the middle. Leon lets it fly.
Yeah.
It's a good swing.
You know what, it's a great play, but I don't like the choice. He already went to Ryan on the first one. I know about redoing. Don't like the choice.
Spread the love. Here we go. Set to the outside. There we go. That's what we just talked about, right?
Yeah. I think that Fisher is starting to get hot, you know, and I like setting him a little bit more, keeping him in the flow, you know. They're taking him out in the back. They need this other kid to, you know, number 14 to – you know, pass a little bit more.
John Cuioca.
Cuioca.
Back to serve. Backspin floater. Ooh, joust at the net. Sorry with the spike. Pass by Matsui. Let's see, this should be good.
Oh, what a shot.
That's a great angle.
You know, he got his feet to that ball. Got his feet, made a nice approach. Kind of turned his shoulders and cut that thing inside the block.
Really cut that thing.
You know, because Sari was expecting it over there. You know, and still wasn't
Cuioca
able to make
back
a play.
With another floater. Oof. Well, I'll tell you, if you're going to serve it out, it better not have backspin on it, right?
You know, you got Ryan Leong left front for you. You need to keep the ball in the court. You know, give him a chance to score you some more points.
High floater. Perfect pass to the middle. Ryan Leong up. Good dig. Setter gets a chance to put his hands on it. Rusty. Takes an aggressive swing, hits the antenna.
Yeah, here's our buddy trying to do a little too much. Rusty Sorry, just too much of that. He didn't need to do that. The block hadn't come all the way out. He had a great dig off of HBA's big guy. Just swing for the big part of the court.
All right, Matsui back to serve. Let's see if he can shift the momentum here.
Nice pass.
Big swing. Matsui unable to come up with it.
That's our boy Caldwell again.
Yep.
The Cody Caldwell show.
Into the game for the Tars, Zach Martin. Another name we've heard several times tonight. Rusty Sorry back to jump serve. Throws it up. Hammers it.
Great oh, what a pass.
Ryan Leong, timing a bit off. Comes up with a block, and they bring it down.
Oh, what a play. You know, I think... Ryan is approaching for a faster tempo set. I mean, they're looking to go a little quicker, and Wes, for some reason, is struggling a little bit, you know, with that tempo. I'm not sure why.
It's a game of inches, and he was a couple inches off. A real good spike there. All right. Received with the hands.
Here's our double quick play again.
Double quick dive by Tompkins, jump.
So Caldwell, he's hitting a combo out of the back. He's hitting the quick in front, the quick in the back. He's hitting the step out, second tempo set off the back.
We see that step out a lot in the ladies' game. Do we see it a lot in the boys?
You know, you don't. You don't see it too much.
Jay Ordaz back. Matsui handles the pass well. Ryan Leong. Look at that high contact. But
you know,
this kid's there.
He's swinging for the big part of the court.
Yeah.
You know, if I had some basketball players that were, you know, middle hitters, I'd probably, you know, working with that one-footed step-out approach, because it's something they do on a regular basis.
Jump serve into the middle of the net. Again, not what HBA needed at this point. Down 6 points to the Tars. Well, I got it, you take it.
Yeah, Matsui, that he can't be backing away. Not at his level of skill.
Next to Ryan, he has to be leaning towards Ryan.
Yeah, and in this rotation, Caldwell's been serving, you know, Ryan over on that side. I think Matsui's got to be, he's got to be pulling Michael Fisher over.
Right.
You know, he's got to say, Michael, you know, come over. You got to pass a little bit more court. I got to cover Ryan's court, you know, part of the court here. So.
Jump serve. Matsui with the perfect pass, bringing it out. That's a good shot.
Ooh.
Oh, they called it out?
They called it out. You know, it looked like a net. I wasn't sure who net. I didn't know if it was the middle hitter, you know, got it on the way down or something.
Another jump serve. Touches
oh,
the net.
What a serve.
And once again, we see Ryan receiving it, Matsui backing off, but.
You know, ironically, the difference in this game is, in this match has become between the two big guys.
Yeah. Great pass to the middle, set to the outside. No one. So HBA able to capitalize on a good pass again. Got Hodson coming into the game to serve for the Eagles.
Yeah, they need to make a push here. They need to start making some, you know, what we call real points.
Okay. Free ball to HBA. Again, timing off. Quick set to the middle. Let's see if they can convert.
For Cuddy. Oh,
and
that's four hits. That thing
that.
Never went over. Right. Never went over.
We might be seeing some tired legs out there.
You know, maybe. I think, you know, a big part here is that, you know, the HBA setters, he's got to get his feet to the ball and get set, you know, so that his location is not going all over the place.
All right, got Curry back and serving it
out. Just hit that.
You got a little room, 23-14, 23-15 at this point.
I think you want to maintain the momentum going into game four. I mean, you don't want to leave any doubt.
Jump serve, pass, nice handled pass. To the middle, giving the setter lots of options. Chooses Rusty Sari.
Yeah, you know, he kind of got away with that. He lucked out. You know, I noticed, I don't know if this is typical of him, but right at contact, when he's contacting the ball, he's turning his head, so he's not even seeing the ball. I don't know if you picking up on that, but it looks like he's mishitting the ball off of his thumb sometimes. And
it might be those clouds that he has to jump through because he's jumping so high, throwing him off a little bit. Set to the outside, touch.
He might be searching for some oxygen or something there, yeah? Too bad. Here again, that's a great swing, great swing by Fisher.
But point HBA, 16-24 now. Let's see if they can pull off a miracle here in Hemeter Gym.
No.
And that's not going to do it. So another game in Newport Harbor, carrying plenty of momentum into the last, or what could be the last game.
Yeah, you know, HBA, they got to come back to game one, what worked well for game one. And you know, Newport Harbor made an adjustment by serving the ball in a little bit more, by taking a little bit of speed off of their serves and getting the ball to Ryan.
Right.
You know,
and what was it in game one? It was Matsui passing nails, digging the ball,
yep,
getting it to the setter.
And, you know, I mean, he's passing the majority of the balls and, you know, the balls that were served in. You know, and the balls were served in were not quite as difficult, and you know, he's putting it on the target, and the setter's dishing to the outsides, and the block's not quite there.
Well, I think the stats for Newport are very spread out. Yeah. They've used just about every weapon they have in their arsenal.
Yeah, and you know, I think that you know, their game plan is still, you know, it was early to go the middle, and you see that they haven't quite been set in the middle as much in the last game and a half. But they haven't needed to. You know, they got HBA to do what they want them to do.
And look at
start
the complexity
the
of their offense is so complex. I mean, it's hard to announce when you got double quick jump. Divac Tompkins coming out from the back row. They got it all, don't they?
Well, it took me, you know, it took me a game to figure it out. But, you know, all I needed to know was Cody Caldwell.
Right.
You know, it's like, you know, just follow Cody Caldwell. And my job would be that much easier. You know, we just follow him. Here you see one of the some of the female athletes at Pono. You got Shannon McCready. She played on the varsity team this year. She'll be a returning player, vying for the starting setting position. Looking to play collegiately. She's got some offers that she's looking to entertain. And
this will be your team next year, we hear.
Well, yeah. I'm kind of excited about it, you know, switching back over to coach the girls. It's been a while since that has taken place, but I'm looking forward.
A lot of adjustments needed?
I don't think so. I got a really good group of kids coming back, and I got some really good kids, you know, moving up, and the program's healthy. Jim Imes did a great job with the program. There's some.
And I'm sure you'll have plenty of competition on the island, right?
That'd be more than my share. Yes. More than enough here.
So. ILH League here on the beautiful island of Oahu. I want to thank you all for joining us tonight on this broadcast of Puna Vision's Clash of the Titans, the first annual of what we hope will be many Clash of the Titans tournaments.
I hope so. This is a neat thing. I would, you know, it's a great opportunity to get schools like Corona and Newport that are kind of the perennial top dogs that, you know, we've always wondered, well, how would we do against the mainland teams?
Exactly. And sometimes Hawaii teams are, thought of a little less because we're on a small island.
Well,
but now that we get the competition coming over here.
Up until 3 years ago, you know, we were playing in the fall. The boys were in the fall and they switched to the spring. So it's a great opportunity. Here we go.
Set to the middle.
Here's Caldwell on a second tempo play coming in the middle again here.
I think you can mistake that swing for a NC2A swing right there.
You know, I think this kid can play at the next level. You know, he's
got the elevation. He's got the mechanics.
He's just got mobility, and he hits a lot of different shots and a lot of different plays.
All right, let's see what they're going to do with this free ball. They call it a double hit. It's probably a good thing.
Well, here again, you'll notice he's going after Ryan Lung.
Right.
You know, he's moved his, you know, he's serving from the left back position here instead of earlier he was serving from the right back position.
Ooh.
Great play by him.
Set to Ryan. Digged up out outside. They're going to call a double hit.
Unfortunate play.
Right.
Unfortunate. Because you know what? This kid, Rusty Sari, that was a great play. Bad toss, and he just kept the serve in. And HBA was in jail.
Yeah, I was wondering if you noticed that, too.
He
basically threw it to the 10-foot line, didn't he? All right. Serve off the net. Sorry with the set to the outside. Good swing. No one there. Great block by HBA. This is a great way for them to start the game.
You know what it is. And you can tell they're jumping around. They're, you know, they're kind of a little bit more up-tempo. It's kind of do or die for them. They want to play a fifth game.
That's right. Matsui with another serve. Floater to Sari. Set to the way outside. Oof. Again, not.
Oh, what a
set.
Dig. What a
Ryan
dig.
Puts it up a good effort. Double. There's Matsui. Oh. They're going to call
it bad
on the setter.
What a great rally.
Great rally. Great digs. This is what we're seeing. This is that spark we saw in the first game by HBA.
Well, and you know what? They need that. They need to play with a little bit more enthusiasm. They need Ryan to come out and be banging and Mike Fisher, you know, banging as well, and Beretta, you know, getting his swings in as well. So
Ordaz serves it right into the net.
Ooh, that was a big rotation for him last game. You know, this kid, Jay Ordaz, I mean, he scored many points in that last game. You know, him to serve that ball in the net doesn't help.
Wes Hatai back to serve for the Eagles. 3-3 tie. Jump serve to the middle, great pass. Quick set to the middle. Footsies bringing it up.
Paul, Will Conley, they're starting to get him back on track again. I think maybe the game plan was, hey, you know what? Let's go back to the middle. We've gone away from it. Let's get the middle on track again.
Great pass by Matsui. Out to the outside. Double block out. Point Eagles.
Oh, what a great hit. You know, his timing was a little off. Just, you know, just swung for the hands. Let it kind of rattle off and out of bounds.
Blockers really need to seal there, don't they?
Yeah, they sure do.
Ryan throwing it up high. Jump serve. Hammers it. Handled easily. Great play. Boy, that was put in his wheelhouse, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah. And here's our Zach Martin again, hitting for the deep part of the court.
Single blocker.
Single block. They dropped in on the angle, and he banged it down. He hit what the block gave him.
That's
what we like to teach our hitters to do. You know, hit what the block gives you. They're going to take
brave
something.
Brave set, too, for him to launch it like that. He had options that were closer and probably more conservative.
Well, it was a tight pass, and he made a great play out of it.
Jump serve. Pass. Ryan handles it again. Launched outside.
Yeah, you know, Michael Fisher, he looks a little tentative. You know, he's playing a little bit like a freshman instead of just kind of banging.
Jump serve to the middle. Boy, put some heat on it.
Yeah, I'm not certain that I would have gone for it there. He definitely went for it. You know, who was that? Connor Curry? Yeah, he's going to Penn State next year. Yeah.
Unbelievable. Coming out of the back row.
Here's our guy Caldwell again.
He's
passing. He's hitting a second tempo, you know, play out of the pipe. Not quite what we call a BIC, but a little bit higher, and he's doing it all.
You can tell these Newport players have played with each other quite a bit, haven't they?
Yeah.
They got real rhythm. They know where they're going to be most of the time.
Yeah, they do. And I'm not sure if they play club together or not. I assume that they probably do.
Set to the outside. Block.
West Hatai, he's starting to get Beretta on track here, you know, and I think he needs to. You know, if Michael Fisher's not handling the play, he's got to get Beretta. He's got to get somebody else other than Ryan going. So,
all right, got number 11. Chad Beretta serving right into the net.
You know, there may be a part here where, you know, Tione has told him, hey, you guys got to go for it a little bit, but, you know, take a couple chances. So.
That's right. Matsui with the pass, set to the outside. Nice dig, coming across to Sari again. Free ball, gonna back set it. Libero.
Yep. There he goes.
There he is. What's that guy's name again?
Caldwell, Cody Caldwell. Hey, you know, I'm looking at this Rusty Sari and I'm thinking, hey, this kid's from California. I don't think so. I mean, you know, he looks like he should be playing at Hilo or Kamehameha or, you know, here in the islands, not from California.
Ooh. Look at this. We get a...
What a serve.
A little bit of luck there, I guess, but off the net. Get some love from the net there. And we got a timeout.
Ooh, we got an early time.
Early timeout, 6-10.
Yeah.
Probably good call there.
I think so. I think, you know, his guys are, they're playing a little bit more aggressive, a little bit more emotion. But they're still a little kind of, you know, shell-shocked, a little gun-shy, so to speak.
Right.
So he kind of wants to keep their confidence level up. You know, here you see Danny Glenn. He's kind of, you know, talking to his guys a little bit, you know, talking to his blockers. Hey, you know, is it sometimes you need to, he's talking to them about sweep blocking, you know, which is a way for you to get much higher and whatnot, but it comes with some kind of faults to it. You know, you're not quite set. And I think he's telling them, hey, just get there and seal the area. You know, let's take away a good, solid area.
Well, and that all starts with good footwork at the net, right?
Sure does. Yeah. Sure does. So, you know, but a good coach, he was telling them about what they need to do with their feet, not, you know, blocking balls or so.
Easy serve to the middle. Quick set, blocked. Brought back up, another tight joust at the net. Who's going to win that every time, yeah?
Oh, great play by Austin Bagby up there, you know. Heads up, the ball's in his area, he just went after it. So,
floater to Matsui to the middle. Again, bringing the setter too far out.
You know, interesting that, they're going with kind of lollipop serve, but it's effective.
Well,
you know, is that they're throwing it's kind of a different tempo to it, you know, and it's throwing a
Matsui needs to pass that ball up further, doesn't he?
And you know what? He's too good a player for that not to be on target.
Is. Yeah.
So.
All right, number 4, Ren Sugihara in the middle of the net.
You know, that's kind of one of those things. Yeah. You battle to get a side out. Just battle.
That's
got
to be frustrating as a coach.
Oh, man. That guy's just got to take a little something off and put the first one in. Give us a chance, you know.
Sorry with the serve. Out. All right, we're trading.
You know, a place like that, you're keeping HBA in the game
here.
That's
right.
You know, HBA is going to, they hang around long enough. They're good enough where they'll chip away and take you to a fifth game.
Have you ever said to a player, serve it underhand? Just get it in. Have you ever said that to a player?
Yeah, my second grade class, maybe, you know. You mean a varsity player?
A varsity player.
No.
Have you ever?
No. No, we don't serve it underhand at the varsity level. Serve it underhand.
All right, well, we got 13-8. Tars ahead. We promised that Tars story. Hopefully we'll get a timeout and be able to explain why they're called the Tars. Ordaz off the net, back of the hand. Again.
Here's our boy Jay Ordaz in game 3. Right. He scores plenty of points. First time around, he puts the thing in the net, and now he gets a full tape dribble.
That's right. He has served a lot in these games. Again with the jump serve. Again into the net, but this time can't convert.
You know, I got to give this kid credit. That's a hard skill to be able to do. Come off the bench. You've been sitting for a while. And to go up and just take a rip at it. But you know what? His coach is not real happy with him on the sidelines here.
Serve to the back row. Great serve. Oh. Quick set to the middle, ineffective. Ryan Leong puts it in and gets it in the wheelhouse. Takes a good swing. Going to take another swipe at it.
Good nice
dig by Sari.
Oh.
Yeah, foot came under. That was cool.
Yeah. Little
instant
tight.
Replay would show
little tight. Jackson Carmack didn't quite get there, you know. You know, it ended up being a farther way for him to go than I thought it was.
Right.
So.
All right, HBA with the serve. West Hatai. Great serve. Let's see if he dumps it. Oh, boy, great. Bringing that back to the hitter like that.
Oh, I thought that thing was going over.
Me too.
You know,
I thought he was going to dump it over with his left.
Yeah, I mean, he went up and went after it, you know, and helped his hitter.
Another serving mistake.
Yeah, you know, I don't know, but he looked like he might be a little tired on that. You know, he's hit a ton of balls here tonight.
Yeah.
Well, they can't afford to have him go
Newport
tired.
Well, Harbor was snorkeling this morning at Hanama Bay, we know, so. Something that I'm sure their legs aren't used to. Back row, set to the middle. Going to go with the soft. What do you think? What did you see there, Peter?
Well, the set was a little bit tight. He got there a little bit late, you know, and Michael Fisher, Beretta was just max there waiting for him. So
Ryan Leong back with the serve. Let's see if he drops the hammer again. Ooh, threw that way too far out in front of him, didn't he?
Yeah, you could tell right from the get-go that his timing was going to be off on that one.
So. Jump serve is a tough serve. Do you know who's accredited with inventing the jump serve?
You know,
a little bit of trivia for you there.
I don't.
You don't. It was Jose da Silva.
I was going to say Brazilian, somebody from Brazil.
Brazilian in the early 80s. Boy, launched that one.
You know, I'm impressed that you know that.
Oh, I'm a huge volleyball fan. Always have been.
You know, in the 80s.
Growing up on the beaches of Santa Monica, you can't not be a huge volleyball fan. Okay, here we got another jump serve coming back. Matsui to the middle. Going to set Fisher.
Here it comes.
There it is. There's that
dump. There's your dump shot.
You know, my favorite shot in the game, by far. Because
you know,
it's so frustrating for the defense, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, man.
There's just nothing.
You know, especially if you've got somebody that, you know, in Jackson Carmack's case, you know, in the previous rotation, he was in the back row. Yeah. And the ball looked like it was going over, and he went up and was able to bring it back.
Bring it back, yeah.
You know, and on that one, shoot, you know, you're thinking front row, back row.
Well, I'll tell you.
The front row, and he dumps
one of
it.
The best setters I've known to dump is Mike Seeley, the new head coach at UCLA women's program. But watching him through high school and college. You know, when a setter can establish, hey, I can dump, right?
Right.
Now you have to put a blocker on that setter, which just throws off an entire defense, right?
You know, it's a huge advantage, but, you know, also remind us that Mike Seeley is 6'7" and has arms that, you know, go down to his ankles.
Yeah, one of the first tall setters kind of broke the mold there, right?
Well, and extremely athletic.
Yes.
You know, I mean, not just kind of big and long and kind of
Here's
awkward.
Another young up-and-comer, Josh Taylor, that we'll see in the next game. Those of you watching us on the West Coast may want to tune in for the 7 o'clock game. Josh Taylor is generally known as one of the best, most highly recruited players in the country.
Yeah, and you know what? He's only a junior. So
that's right.
We'll see what happens.
Hodson with the serve to the back row. I see some options here coming out, kind of paintbrushes the spike there. Leong going to take a swing to the libero, Siqueira. Rusty Sarri with into the net. I love saying that. The libero Siqueira. I feel like I'm announcing a Spanish Italian league or something.
You might be thinking you're watching the Brazilians again here.
Hodson with another serve. Bit of an overpass, brings it back.
Again, great play by Carmack. You know, here again, the ball looked like it was going over. This time he is in the front row, so he could have dumped it.
Nice hands. Number 14 coming into the game, Kevin Rickshaw, the young pup.
Conley with the serve, great serve.
Took a swing at it, didn't he?
Guy, you know, and the setter got him one-on-one, too. You know, he's got to be able to put that ball away.
Yeah, Beretta has to be able to put that. You get the single block, the good set. Set the table for him. Oh, boy. This net seems to be going Newport Harbor's way every time.
Yeah, it sure does. Oh, I like this kid. This kid, Max Richley. Boy, this kid came in when they needed a dig early in the match, and he made a great dig. I like him.
Jump floater set to the middle. No block. Still dug. Joust. Oh.
Too bad.
He almost got it there. Fortin.
Too bad. He needed to bring that just a little farther off the net, you know, for his hitter. Who is that? Kevin Rickshaw.
Kevin Rickshaw standing at about 7 feet, 2 inches, weighing about 112 pounds, it looks like.
Oh, man. Yeah, but if he fills out, boy, watch out.
Sorry, with the big swing.
You know, that's the first swing I've seen him tonight where everything was on.
That's right.
You know, and
reminded me of Alan Allen.
Yeah.
Coming out of the
former
outside.
Former UH Rainbow.
Overpass. Let's see if Rickshaw. Oh, we had some contact at the net between hands, but
here we go.
Coming up. Sorry. Up.
Again, wow, you got a little help there, huh?
Yeah.
A little tape dribble there.
Newport is getting the help. All right, we got number 12. Carmack back serving. Floater. Let's see what they call it. They call it in.
Baby.
Going over Matsui's head. He opts to let it go out. Ace. Love those as a coach. I don't know if there's anything better in the game than a floater that hits the back line, right? All right, we got some action. 16-24. Game could be over in a moment here. Stick around, we're going to try and get a player interview. We'll see if that works out. HBA with the serve. Match point. Perfect pass to Rickshaw.
Oh, nice save.
That was a nice save. Timing is off. Young set to the middle. Up. Two.
Oh, my.
Number six.
And there again,
Caldwell.
Cody Caldwell.
That's right.
Boy, that was a great, great match by Newport Harbor. You know, making adjustments after game one. I don't know if they were still had the snorkels in their mouths, you know, from Hanama Bay this morning. But they did what they had to. Made the adjustments and, came back. Well, and
looks like we're going to get an interview with Mr. Caldwell in just a moment here. Doing the ceremonial shake of the hands after the game. HBA has nothing to be disappointed with, really. I mean, they played with one of the best teams in the country.
Yeah, you know, I think that, you know, they, after game one, they kind of didn't really, you know, have things clicking for them, but they can't be hanging their heads. They had a great match and did some great things, and, you know, they need to be proud of what they were doing. So,
all right, well, we're sitting here with our MVP of the game, Cody Caldwell. Congratulations, Cody.
Thank you.
So you want to tell us about the game? What were your impressions?
Well, we knew we had to come out strong. They were a pretty good team. They had a lot of ball control, and they had that number nine who could hit the ball. We know that we had to get.
Did you guys have a game plan to?
Yeah, we had to serve tough and keep them off the net and get them out of their situation.
You guys did a great job of that, didn't they, Peter?
Yeah, we served pretty well, and that's what helped us.
You know, I'm curious. So what Coach Danny told you guys between games one and two, you know, we're watching, and he was a little animated, to say the least. You know, tell us a little bit about what went on in that huddle.
He knew what we could do. We came out first game super flat, and he just knows we're so much better than that. He came in here, he talked to us, he told us that that we really needed to start digging balls, and that's what would change the momentum. And because we didn't do that first game, we needed to hit the ball on the court. We were making a lot of errors, and that's kind of what changed it for us.
Good deal.
Yeah. Well, you're enjoying the island.
Yeah, it's really nice.
I heard you guys went snorkeling this morning.
Yeah, we went to Hanama Bay. It was
really fish?
Nice. Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
All right. Any other plans before you guys take off?
I think we just got a free day tomorrow. Do whatever we want. But, yeah, weather's been good. Like it.
Well, maybe we get you guys on some boards. I hear, you know, Waikiki's got a little South Shore brewing. And,
yeah, we have some surfers. You know, I'm not one of them, but we have
break.
Surfers. Yeah.
Yeah, we, you know. You never know. They got guys that can teach you down in Waikiki. A little, you know, a little team discount or something.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. Well, we want to say thank you for coming, and we enjoyed watching you play.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Well, that's about it for this game. We're going to be coming on at 7:00 Hawaii time. Those of you in on the West Coast may want to stick around, watch two great teams play this next match.
Yeah, this one is truly going to be the Battle of the Titans. Corona Del Mar is big. You got Punahou is also, you know, big in some spots. And I think it's going to be a great match with some great volleyball, you know.
Well, it's definitely a preview of things to come in the NC2A, too. We probably have at least half a dozen guys who will go on to play at the next level in this upcoming match.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. These guys, they may even be some teammates. You know, play at the same university together, and we'll see. So,
all right. Well, that's it for us here in Honolulu. We want to thank you for joining us this afternoon or tonight, whatever the case may be. And aloha.